Yo, what's going on, guys? It is your boy Ral. I am coming at you guys with a updated graphics video with NVIDIA settings and graphics settings, also my controller settings that I use and what I believe to be the best controller settings in the game. So with that being said, let's go ahead and talk about it, shall we? All right, so this is all up to date now, almost season 2 on Caldera. I'm going to be running full screen on 240 hertz and 1440p. I highly recommend investing in a 1440p monitor and a 27 inch monitor if you can afford it and if that is possible. The reason for this is because if you are on PC, this field of view being on 120, if you're on a 27 inch monitor, feels absolutely amazing on 27 inches. It doesn't even seem as zoomed out. I had this issue around 24 inch monitors. I simply could not just see as well as on a lower FOV. I upgraded by 3 inches and 120 FOV is so much easier to use. So highly recommend doing that. And then as far as everything else goes, everything else is pretty standard. We got disabled 100 aspect ratio on automatic, disabled custom frame limit. My GPU tends to get pretty hot. If a lot of you guys come into the stream, you guys are like, yo, Rel, your PC is freaking 400 degrees Celsius. No, it's like, it'll get up to like 80. It'll get up to like 80, 81, 82. And you know, I don't want my freaking thing to start on fire down there. So I give her a little bit of a cooldown in between games. We got a 60 during the menu, 300 during the gameplay, and out of focus on 30. Brightness is going to be different for every single person. Just pick roughly around a brightness where that middle one is just either invisible, or just you could barely see it. I like to have it where both of the first two boxes are not visible, personally, because I just feel like the game looks better like that way, and I have easier time seeing. Display gamma, guys, for a lot of people that have hard times not seeing dark corners and stuff like that, if you actually put this display gamma to the 2.4 BT, I know a lot of other streamers that actually do play on this setting and the game does look really good. I just personally prefer RGB, but if you don't like the colors of RGB, I highly recommend trying this one out. Disabled is a must. I don't want to get any frames getting smoked, and then enabled plus the boost for my display. As far as this goes, you need to have this on 50. You get more aim assist having this on 50, and you need to have your ADS unaffected. Otherwise, you'll have more visual recoil without having it unaffected. All right, so now my settings are just pretty much low everything. It's gonna be low, very low, low. Particle quality is on high, so you can see loot and stuff off the ground easier. Everything else is disabled. Definitely want this on disabled. If you have this on enabled or standard quality, you will be getting packet burst. So do not have that one enabled. One of my recent settings I have actually changed is my filmic strength. I used to have this all the way on 0, but with me having anti-aliasing off, as you guys will see down here, this actually does give the game a little bit more of a sharp look while still being able to take off anti-aliasing for that frame boost, because anti-aliasing will make your frames better when you have it turned off. And in my opinion, I think the game runs smoother and it just looks better to me personally. So film grain is on 0 though, but filmic strength is on 1. This is on disabled. This is disabled, 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 low, enabled, enabled, low, disabled, disabled, disabled. All right, now interface, you want this to be colorblind. Some people like having their stuff on, you know, all this crazy stuff. I have it disabled, but if you do have it on enabled, be sure you have it on world or both, because if you do not have it on world or both, you will have it only on your interface and you won't actually have colorblind filter in your game. So just make sure you have that on. My heads up is actually 0. This means I have less movement of my head to look at my mini map. My mini map, rather than being way up here on my screen, if I have it on 0, 0, it's actually going to be like right here, which for me is like right there. That's like a way less movement that I have to, like, you know, look over to see my mini map. So I would recommend trying 0. If you don't like it, then, you know, whatever you're comfortable with, be sure you have this on square. Otherwise, you will not have as much visibility as somebody that does. Everything else is pretty much standard. Here, this is all optional too. If you're on PC, I like to see my packet loss so I know if I'm lagging or not. I also like to have my server latency on so I know if I'm in a high ping server as well, so that way I'm not like absolutely delusional if I get literally freaking insta killed or something, or my bullets aren't registering whatsoever. I don't know, it's probably packet loss, or, you know, I just know I'm not missing shots. And it's like, you know, if I got 10% packet loss, I'm shooting right at somebody, it's good. It's for the mental, you know, it's good for the mental. So I recommend having these two on. GPU temperature, I also have this on, so I know if my PC is about to explode. All right, that's it on that. I recommend using midnight mode on your audio. I did a video on it last. Phenomenal. It makes footsteps louder. It makes explosions quieter. Literally perfect for this game, because this game is loud. Caldera is loud compared to Verdansk. Something's always blowing up every 5 seconds. I would recommend throwing that midnight mode on, baby. And then if you do have it on, have your master volume on 100 and your effects on 100, and you're gonna have to have that mix amp cranked. Everything else for the most part is pretty standard as well. When it comes to your speakers and headphone device, just be sure if you're trying to use surround sound that you are using your surround sound. For me, this is my only audio device, so it's the same exact one as a communications device. Just be sure you are selecting the correct audio. All right, and then as far as sensitivities and scents go, I personally prefer tactical flipped. I would always have a problem meleeing way back when. This is when dinosaurs were still on the earth. We're talking like Call of Duty 4 vibes. It was the first time I switched to tactical. I would just melee a lot when I was trying to like just aim. So I like tactical because I could have a full delicious juicy grip on my controller and not have to worry about meleeing or any of that stuff. And I just feel like drop shotting and all that stuff is just a lot easier on tactical. And then I also do flip my R1 and R2 because I personally, when clawing in particular on this game, I have just a way better feel on the controller shooting with this puppy instead of shooting with this guy down there. I just think it feels great. And I feel like it responds faster too. You definitely want your minimum, your left stick minimum to be on 0.05 or as close to 0.03, 0.04 as you can. I wouldn't go much lower because you're going to have input delay, or not input delay, but stick drift. And it's not going to be a good time because your aim is going to be aiming by itself and it's going to be hard to control. So, you know, I think 0.04, 0.05, 0.06 around that area is perfect. If you have to start cranking this thing way up to get rid of your stick drift, it might be time for a new controller, because the more you crank this up, the more input delay you're actually creating for yourself, because you have to go further from the center mass of your analog stick for it to respond, which means that, let's say this would be 0.05, this is going to register, and if you are on 0.15, then it won't register until you're all the way out here type of vibe. So that's pretty much what it means, is the center of your stick has to be moved more if the higher this value goes for the game to register a movement. So one on this for max, and my sense is 7. I would recommend picking a sense between 5, 6, 7, 8 around that area, because for one, 99% of pro players and Warzone pros, all kinds of professional players that play this game every day, play on a sense around there. And number two, it's gonna help you be more consistent than playing on that super high snappy sensitivity where, yeah, you're gonna be doing some crazy stuff, you're gonna break dance and get a three-piece one every once in a while, but if you stick to a lower sense, you're gonna consistently hit shots at all ranges and you're just gonna be a more consistent player, rather than having the games where you drop 25 and the next game you drop 2, and this, you're gonna just consistently be dropping the same amounts of kills every game. Then I also pick a sense 0.85 to 0.9 around, and I actually do tweak this every now and then. I wouldn't do it all the time or too drastically, but when I hop on, I'm missing some shots, I actually would bump this down one. Or if I hop on and I just feel like my aim just feels a little too sticky or something, I would actually bump it up one. So I actually do mess around with that, but do not change your sense often or you will be shooting circles. Aim response curve type is on dynamic, and then aim assist is on standard, and disable your scaled aim assist. Guys, did a video on this the other day. Your aim assist box gets twice as big. Console guys, before you guys complain, your guys' aim assist box is already this big. But when you're on PC and you have this enabled, it's gonna scale down with your FOV because all your character models are getting smaller. So it's gonna end up being this big. Turn that setting off. You want the big old box in the middle of your screen. Bada bing, bada boom. Everything else you want to be able to hold. Contextual tap is a must. Please have this setting on. It'll make your life a lot easier. You just have to tap the button one time to interact with whatever's going on. Apply one. I don't like the apply all. Some people do. I like to apply one at a time and have complete control instead of like maybe accidentally using a plate when I'm in the middle of a fight or something. I just prefer apply one. Tap to slide, absolutely instrumental for your movement game. You need to have tap to slide on. Just turn it on. Don't ask any questions. Trust me. Tactical sprint, double tap, automatic tac sprint as well. Just like tap to slide, I was so stubborn and I took like a year to switch this setting. And at first I thought it was, it's not all that good. And then I realized, holy crap, this setting is nuts. It will literally have your movement on another level. Just be sure you're not sprinting at everybody and sprinting there. No, sprint, get yourself to some cover, you know, sprint, hit a slide cancel to some cover. Then you're here, boom. And then, all right, you got this guy down, you kill them, boom, get to more cover. It just makes you so mobile, but be sure you're still playing smart and using cover to your advantage and not just thinking that you're going to just, you know, slide tackle everybody on the map. That's not going to happen. You're going to die and you're going to turn the setting off thinking that it caused you to die. It didn't. It was your decision making. Parachute auto deploy on disabled. And then let's go ahead and show you guys my NVIDIA settings that I rock here. All right, so my settings that I'm currently using right now is I have pretty much everything off at the top. We're gonna have the first four settings on off, anti-aliasing gamma correction on, anti-aliasing mode on off. We're gonna have backgrounds on off, CPU on all, DSR factors on off, low latency mode, have this on ultra. A lot of people say it doesn't really impact anything, but I don't know, man. I don't know if it's placebo effect, but I had used to have this on off or on low or on whatever. And ever since having it on ultra, I don't know, my game just feels more responsive. I feel like I kill faster. I like having it on ultra, you know, why not? The word is literally ultra. It sounds nice. You know, that sounds like it's doing something. I'm going to go ahead and keep that on ultra. Max frame rate on off, and then fixed refresh as well. You could have it on G-Sync if you do prefer a smoother game, but you are going to have yourself some input delays, so I would not advise that. Power management mode is on maximum performance, application controlled refresh rate as well. This is right here what I actually changed recently. I used to have this on quality, but I actually switched my texture filtering quality to high performance. And I think it feels great, man. Allow LOD bias as on allow. And we're gonna have texture filtering on this one on as well. You want trilinear optimization and high performance here. It's gonna help your game feel smoother, and you're gonna be killing quicker if you're on PC compared to if you have these settings off. Reddit optimization on as well. And then we want this on off. We want vertical sync on off as well. We do not want any input delay. And then that's pretty much it, man. A lot of people also ask, yo, Ral, do you have filters and stuff? Nah, man. If you're on PC, you do not need any filters, in my opinion. Simply go over to your settings right here. You can mess with your colors. This is the one right here that's going to make your game look phenomenal. It's going to be digital vibrance. And you just want to crank this puppy up and make it around, you know. I wouldn't advise going crazy high. Personally, my eyes bleed, but maybe, I don't know, you're like a Navy SEAL or a hawk or something, and it doesn't bother your eyes. If that's the case, go crazy. But I think around, you know, 60 to 70% looks great, and it doesn't make everything look too saturated. So gamma's on 1 as well. My contrast is slightly cranked, and my brightness is also on 50. Mess with your monitor settings first before you go into here. I don't think you should really wiggle stuff around as much. If all these settings are on your monitor, I would rather just get to the raw input on your monitor. Make sure that looks nice, and then that's when you change these up. But definitely the digital vibrance will have your game looking good. All right, with that being said, guys, thank you guys all for watching the video. Hopefully the video was helpful to you. If you guys did enjoy the video, please make sure to leave a like on the video. And please, please, please do not hesitate to subscribe to the channel for more informative content coming your way. You look freaking good. This is your boy, Ral. And I'll see you next time. Bye.